In order to understand the neural basis of brain function, we need to be able to record and stimulate a large population of neurons with high spatial and temporal resolution. The research in my lab is at the interface of biophotonics, MEMS, and neuroscience. We design and build different biomedical devices with a special focus on neural interfaces. Brain is the most complex organ. It consists of billions of neurons that mediate our behavior, ranging from simple motor movements to higher-level cognitive processes, such as thinking, learning, and decision-making. We employ concepts in physics and opportunities in engineering to design next-generation neural interfaces. In particular, we employ concepts in photonics and optics, ultrasonics and acoustics, and electronics to design such devices. We target two main areas of application in my lab. The first is to design neural interfaces that can help fundamental neuroscience, for example, to discover the neural basis of different brain disorders, such as Parkinson's disease and epilepsy. The second area of application in my lab is brain-machine interfaces, where we design non-invasive, robust, and reliable devices that can be interfaced with the brain, using which people can control a computer or a robot directly with the power of their mind. This would particularly benefit people with disabilities. Now we are working on two active projects in my lab. The first is to design a multimodal acousto-optic neural interface technique in which we use non-invasive ultrasound waves from outside the brain to define and steer the trajectory of light within the brain tissue. Using this technique, we can do deep brain optogenetic stimulation. And one of the applications is to design new therapeutics for Parkinson's disease. The second active project in my lab is to design optoelectrical neural interfaces entirely made in a biocompatible polymer platform. One of the challenges in this area is to design devices that are small enough that can be safely implanted, but at the same time they can last long in a biological medium, for example, the brain tissue. Therefore, we need to employ concepts in physics, material science, fabrication techniques, and engineering methods to design devices that not only perform well in a short period of time, but also can last long in the brain tissue. If you think how small computers and handheld smartphones and gadgets have changed human life, you can imagine that the application of next generation neural interfaces will take this to the next level, and the applications obviously will go beyond just treating or diagnosing a brain disorder or mental disease. We will witness major changes in human life enabled by next generation neural interfaces.